Honorable and respected brothers and elders, you might recall a couple of weeks ago I was speaking about, and I mentioned the work of Dawah and Tabligh, and I mentioned about how it's a very effective way in calling unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By when I gave that example, and because I said I have an affiliation, because my Islah was through Tabligh. Obviously I was just one guy that was off the track. I was a guy that was off track, and someone, alhamdulillah, some brothers came, gave me da'wah, gave me an invitation, and I accepted, alhamdulillah. But that is no way mean that we should discredit the efforts of other people. The word actual da'wah, yam jagadana da'wat ka kaam, da'wat. Da'wat comes from da'a yad'u, meaning to call towards. So they are calling towards deen, madaris call towards deen, ulama also in their various ways call towards deen. So by mentioning an affiliation which I have does not discredit the other efforts that are taking place. Yani jo dusre kaam ho rahe na hame unko qabool karna chahiye. Aap urdu se mein sab jante na jante na to bhai agar kahin aur kaam ho raha hai to hame usko manna chahiye ki theek hai ye bhi apna kaam kar raha hai lekin daawat ka ek kaam hai, ek kism ka kaam hai. Because when the word da'wah comes from da'a yad'u bulana, and tabligh comes from the word ballagha yuballighu tabligh, pohnchana. Kya pohnchaya ja raha hai? What is sent? What is given? The message unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen. Kya pohnchaya ja raha hai? Quran, Sunnah, Islam, and so on. So if other individuals are doing this in their own capacity, then hume bhi manna chahiye ki ye bhi daawat ka kaam hai. So they are also doing the effort of deen. There is, some people generally say this, and this needs a bit of islah. So I've heard some people say this, hence I repeat it. Some people say that Maulana Ilyas Rahmatullah revived the effort of da'wah. Yani ke goya ke, before there was a period of time when it wasn't existent, and he re-revived it. This statement, even though, like I said, main phir bhi kahun, my islah happened through tabligh, lekin jo theek hai, wo theek hai, jo ghalt hai, wo ghalt hai. May whatever is good is good, and whatever is incorrect, we have a haq to say that that's not right. If someone says for a period of time, you know, that after the Sahaba tabi'un or tabi'in, tabu tabi'in, there was a period of time when the Ummah wasn't calling unto Allah, this is a big khiyana and a big deception. And why I say that is because for 1400 years, what have ulama been doing? For 1400 years, madaris, what have they been doing? Shah Waliullah Muhaddith Dehlawi Rahmatullah Alayhi, some great scholars of the past, he had 1,000 madaris in Delhi alone. 1,000 madrasa the Delhi mein sirf. To kya hum wo daawat ka kaam nahi kar rahe the? Tabligh ka kaam nahi ho raha yahan pe? Matlab ke alhamdulillah, I say this again, meri islah tabligh through hui, lekin main ye nahi kahunga ki jo baki dusre kaam kar rahe wo kaam nahi hai. That's ghalat. Ye ghalat hai, ye ravaiya bilkul theek nahi hai. Because it's like a wheel, right? Ek wheel hai aur uske mukhtalif kind of like shaakhein hain. Everything lends support to everything. There is a need for difa'i kaam in the ummah, defense, politics, da'wah, islah, education, madaris. This is all the big wider circle. If we say, for example, like I said, if he, rahmatullahi alayhi, revived this effort, then this is going to be a khiyana under all those ulama that have passed. So this is why it's very important for us not to fall into this ifrat and tafrit. The good we salute, but if there's anything negative, then we should say that that's not correct. And this is the two differences between an alim speaking about da'wah and tabligh and an average person speaking about the work of da'wah and tabligh. Sometimes some people may have had an experience of a particular person and they'll say, "Yaar, ye jamaat ka kaam theek nahi hai because ye bande theek nahi hai." But they don't represent all of the effort. They're not a spokesperson, they're not a representative, meaning they're not the head of it. So why do we have to get into these ikhtilafat? What happens on an individual basis is an individual thing. Nevertheless, and throughout the ages, we have to understand that because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew the mizaj of the people, nothing was specifically fixed. So like, for example, salah. How many salah are there in a day? 5. Fasting in the month of Ramadan, 29 or 30 days, but it's fixed in Ramadan. Ramadan kamina. Then zakat is fixed, you pay 2.5%. Hajj is also fixed in the days of Hajj. Okay, so you have obviously, let's not digress, but we have a certain number of days within the days of Hajj. So then anyway, with the effort of da'wah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left it very general, left it very generic. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam adopted written means, spoken, going individually to one person, two people, groups of people, heads of clans, leaders. You know, if you read a book by called Hayat al-Sahaba by Maulana Yusuf Khan Dehlvi, rahmatullah, you'll see how the different methods Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam employed to give the work, to give the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is so varied and vast. We can't say only one method will be correct because it's not fixed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam adopted different means to call unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, one thing which the Quran does speak about certain usul. Quran speaks about certain principles. This is what Quran does do. So for example, when it mentions Fir'aun was Musa and Harun was sent to Fir'aun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions قُولُ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. When you speak to him, speak to him softly. And then also he mentioned that to give da'wah with maw'idat al-hasana. With correct counsel, and also when you speak, it should be in such a way. Of course, we learn from the hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentions obviously now when we speak to people, we should speak with khair khahi, with good. Ad-deen un-nasiha, deen is wanting khair khahi for the fellow individual. So because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that the mizaj would change, that's why it's left very flexible, and things have changed through over the times. Our job, my dear brothers, is not to look down upon any individual. If some efforts of deen are taking place, let them take place. If some efforts we think are better than others, the better and who's not better, this is Allah, He's the judge, not us. He's the judge. We're mukallaf of just making a little bit of effort. Okay, what I have an issue with personally is when people make zero effort and then they want to make tanqeed than everybody else. Like they literally don't do nothing themselves and they'll say, "That's they're wrong, they're wrong, they're wrong, they're wrong." But everyone's wrong, but what are you doing then? So I have an issue with that. But however, we should also be accustomed to look for the good in each other and not negative, not necessarily the bad. Like for example, I don't want to mention where I was because there's a certain gathering and it's run by an organization and the organization does fantastic work, but there were some mistakes which the brother had mentioned. I went for a training course and then he said, like for example, he was saying, "I don't agree with this effort of tabligh because they only focus on Muslims and this is wrong because of this." And he went on for about a couple of minutes to tell and to say why he thought it was wrong. I didn't make a rebuttal, I didn't respond, I said leave it, and afterwards I would just talk to the brother individually, because it was a close room, it was only a couple of people, and I knew that the people that were there for the training, they came with me on journey, so I can explain to them afterwards. But let it carry on, and I'll talk to the brother separately. And I said to him that, look, this effort is designed just for making effort on Muslims. That's their speciality. You are not going to become a Maulana by going in the effort of tabligh. You're not going to become a Hafidh of Quran. Well, some people have, mashallah. But it's not so straightforward. If you want to study the ilm of deen, fiqh, usul, hadith, tafsir, usul al-hadith, usul al-tafsir, aqidah, mantiq, and all these different subjects which you study in alim class, then go to the madrasa. That's where you're going to learn that. Okay, if you think that change has to take place on a government level, politics, then by going to politics, then you know, going to something else. But this effort here is specifically one-sided for a reason. However, what I would say to that brother, I said to the brother is that I understand the difference because you're geared just to making effort on non-Muslims, but that's also needed as well. That's also a very big form of da'wah. Okay, you're making effort on non-Muslims, dispelling the myths of Islam, you know, like undoing the hostility which people have, introducing to them the call of Tawheed, mentioning Islam. That's, mashallah, brilliant. But that's your specialism. Let them do their specialism. And let the others do their specialism, and so on. Taki har banda jo na, they say in Urdu, bhai, har fan maula ki zarurat nahi hai. Harfan Mola, ke carpenter bhi hai, plumber bhi hai, mashallah, a jack of all trades. In this zamana, by a jack of all trades is not going to work. Specialize. And that's what some of the brothers do. So they specialize on one effort, someone specializes on another thing, someone specializes on another thing. And likewise, when we think of this like this manner, we will regard each other as brothers. Okay, when I hear, for example, that there's a gathering in my neighboring town and they had, mashallah, a gathering, I should feel happy. Alhamdulillah, okay, look, they're doing the effort of deen and people are going there. Sadly, this does creep in. What creeps in? Okay, people, when they see the efforts of other people, unko jalan hoti hai dil mein. They feel annoyed, it annoys them, frustrates them. It makes some people angry, na'uzubillah. Why should it make someone angry? Do you understand? Why should it make somebody angry for? If I hear, for example, alhamdulillah, I run a madrasa in Crawley, okay? We have just under about 100 students. If I hear of another madrasa opening in the same area, I should feel happy, alhamdulillah. Because I can only cater for 100, we need more. So when more open, this is the they call it the litmus test. When you hear of them opening, are you happy or are you sad? If you're happy, then alhamdulillah, Januki, you're sincere. And if it pains you, makes you upset to hear Qiyad, why are they starting something? Then you've got to question, why are you upset for? Why are you angry for? Are you taking it personally? You're taking it as a personal attack? Are you thinking that you have a monopoly on this? The question arises then, are you really sincere? Are you doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because yeh masjid mein bhi hota hai. Like for example, you go to a certain masjid. This is how ridiculous it is. I went to a masjid, and I'm not going to mention the area, because we want our object of even talking about negativity is for islah, not to ridicule. So I went to a masjid, I came out, and the brother said to me, Maulana, this masjid, they want to call you for bayan, can you go there? And I was like, when? He goes, maybe sometime in the near future. I was like, Tika, where are the satis? Did they come for the masjid? He said, Nini, wani out there, they keep themselves separate. They didn't come for the bayan. I'm like, and literally, no joke, right? You know, from here to where the parking machine is, so literally you're looking at what, 50 meters? That's how far the masjid was. And I was like, why didn't they come? And then he mentioned, based on a difference of opinion which they have. This is not us. It's not like one is Fulduli and Deobandi or Tablighi and Jamaat-e-Islami, not that big. It was based on Surti Buruchi, Dhaka Silat. Understand like that. Punjabi Pathan. You know, Ya Rab. I'll tell you one thing. My job is to talk about the good, but also to highlight the bad as well. Because this exists in communities. But when we think of Sautang Nazar, ke I'm a Pathan, I'm a Punjabi, I'm a Silati, I'm from Dhaka, I'm a Gujarati, I'm Surti, I'm Baruchi. And then what happens is that we break up into small little groups. This masjid, they didn't want to come because the culture and the clan was different from ours. So we're not going into that masjid. But you have to. So I have to drive 300 miles back so I can deliver a lecture because they can't walk 50 meters because of their ego. Maine kaha nahi, main nahi jaunga. Agar is buniyad pe ho, if it's on this basis, main nahi jata. Because yeh fitna hai. This is fitna. Bhai, aap sab Urdu samjhne wale na, yeh fitna hai. This is not khair in this now. So I said, nahi, I'm sorry, tell them main nahi jaunga. Or why didn't they come for the gathering? Unko chahiye tha ki wahan aaye. But the fact that they didn't come, I'm not coming now. Now you've said this, but you want me to come back on this basis? Nah. Because there's no khair in that. Because when I go there, this masjid, then you're not going to go there. Because you're different caste, you're different culture, different clan. I said, I'm sorry, but I don't fall into this nonsense. Bhai, make it the job, main to half gorong. Make it the bagun phir. Where am I going to run to? I'm half Pakistani, half English. Bhai, if both sides fall like that, I'm not even going to be a Pakistani, I'm not even going to be a part of the English. Where do I fit in then? But what we should think is that if you said La ilaha illallah, then that person is a Muslim. Khalas, end of. So keep this in mind without sidetracking. What did I say? That when we hear other efforts taking place, we should feel happy. Alhamdulillah, that's my fellow Muslim brother. They're making effort. And the maqsad for which I established this masjid, the maqsad which I established this madrasa, they're also doing the same thing. If I feel I've got a masjid here, why is there a need for another masjid? Why is there a need? And this happens, and it did happen even within local areas I know of as well, where there's a need in the community. So one place establishes it, the other end of town they want to establish a masjid. It was the committee members of this masjid that were objecting to the plans of that masjid. So what are you doing it for? Your own self? Are you doing it to be popular? Are you doing it for you to get the wahwa and the praise? Then you're not doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should feel happy. Okay, alhamdulillah, I want to establish a masjid. And we're trying, and what is the object? The object is to connect people to Allah. So if there's 10 masjids like this, alhamdulillah, just maqsad ke liye, the maqsad which I established the masjid, 10 people are doing it now. Alhamdulillah, now there's not one person, now there's 10. We cut each other. And this is the problem. This is my basis of my talk. We should look at each other as one. You understand? Forget culture, forget all this stuff, subhanAllah. If the person is making effort for deen, for me that should be sufficient. When I mean effort for deen, it should be correct. Not that they're calling. There are some incompatible beliefs of Islam that we just can't have. So if somebody, for example, if they rejected a key aqidah, someone said, I don't believe in the Prophet ﷺ as the last Prophet, I believe in the coming of a Messiah, someone else who's not the Prophet Muhammad, then we would say, now hold on a second, that's clearly going against clear tawheed here and risala. If somebody said, I don't believe in there being 30 juz of Quran, I believe there'd be 40. There are some groups like this amongst the Muslims. We would draw the line and say, I'm sorry, but your beliefs are incompatible with us. We still won't be hostile. We won't be hostile with them. We'll say it's up to you to do what you like to do. But when I hear of people like this spreading Islam, then I'm going to have a problem. Then I'm going to feel sad. But then my upset is for who? Why am I feeling angry and upset? For who? For myself? Nay, lillah. Because I don't want incorrect aqa'id and batil to spread. So here there's not even that issue. But when it's, for example, now we kind of agree on the same page. Okay, you may tie hands here or here or loudly or... But that's your business. But if the message of deen is being spread, alhamdulillah, for me that's sufficient. So we, especially in UK, need to think like this a bit more. Because we are a minority within a minority. Okay, we're not just foreigners, but we're also foreign Muslims. So this is an issue which we have. And alhamdulillah, the people are wonderful people. They're tolerant, they're accepting and so on. But we need to present ourselves as having the best before people can be convinced that it is the best. But if we are always bickering and infighting amongst ourselves, someone, you should go to this sheikh, this is my sheikh, this is my madrasa, this is my khanqah, this is my masjid, your masjid, then believe me, it won't be long before we break up into even more factions than we currently already are. I'll leave it as this because time has come to an end. But make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us tawfiq. On just khulasa at the end, just remember this one thing. Shaytan makes us do this because he does not want to see the nusrat of Allah coming down. So we fall victim to this. What did I say? Shaytan hamil rata hai. Shaytan makes us fight. Why? Because he knows once Muslims fight, then the rahmah of Allah will go. There's a long history behind Laylatul Qadr. You guys may know, so there was two Muslims fighting, it was fixed. But because of two Muslims having an argument, the Prophet ﷺ, he was made to forget the day of Laylatul Qadr. It was fixed. Allah told him, this is the day. He saw two Muslims fight, it went away. Allah took it away. That was the nahusat and the effects of two Muslims arguing. So when people are saying we're not going to that masjid because they're not, you know, they're on batil or they're from this area, I'm from this area, we're rich, they're poor, we're bigger people, they're lower people, then subhanAllah, Allah's rahmah, it will go away completely. May Allah save us and guide us, inshallah. Give us the ability to practice what's been said. Wa sallallahu ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.